Not so long ago, Home Assistant introduced iBeacon support, and I decided to buy one iBeacon from AliExpress to test it out for you, so you don't have to do the same. But what actually are the iBeacons? And they can be used for what? How to add one in Home Assistant? And what to do after that? Let's find out together. iBeacon is a protocol developed by Apple back in 2013. For good or for bad, this technology was not as widely adopted as the AirPlay, for example. But since then, different vendors, mainly Chinese one, have made iBeacon compatible hardware transmitters, usually called beacons or iBeacons. These iBeacons are Bluetooth low energy or BLE devices that broadcast their identifier to nearby smartphones, tablets, and other portable electronic devices. The electronic devices, on the other hand, can be set to perform different actions when in proximity to an iBeacon. That was one of the use cases of the iBeacons. The other one that I'll demonstrate you in a minute is using the iBeacon as kind of an indoor positioning system. That means I will attach the iBeacon to an item like keys or cat, and I'll track that item or poor animal with the help of Home Assistant. And if you don't have Home Assistant yet, what are you doing with your life? Go get one. It is free and fun. On top, I have a webinar where I'm talking about the 4 official and supported ways to get Home Assistant, plus one secret but stupid easy way to start Home Assistant in under 5 minutes on your PC. My webinar is completely free and the registration is open right now on my website, automatelight.pro/webinar. Anyways, before we continue to the Home Assistant part, let's quickly talk about the iBeacon device that I bought from AliExpress. The exact model is Physicom FSC-BP108, and it is in the list of known working devices in Home Assistant. The working range of my iBeacon is up to 400 meters in an open area, and it can last up to, attention here, 6 years. And after that, I have to put a new CR3032 battery, which is very cheap. This Physicom iBeacon is IP67 waterproofed. It supports Bluetooth 5.1, which is great, and it cost me around $20. If you want to buy the same, I will put an affiliate link in the video description. This iBeacon can also work with iOS and Android, but who cares about that when we have Home Assistant in place? Saying that, let's see how I can add the iBeacon in Home Assistant. Inside Home Assistant, I'll press the C button to invoke the search bar. Really sorry for this last delay before the action part of this video, but there are some requirements that needs to be met so you can add the iBeacon to Home Assistant. The first two requirements are implied. You have to have working Home Assistant 2022.10 or greater, and you need an iBeacon device. The next important requirement is to have Bluetooth support on the device where Home Assistant is installed. The Bluetooth support can work out of the box if you have a device like Raspberry Pi 4, for example, and Home Assistant is running on it. The other option is to add a Home Assistant compatible Bluetooth dongle. The last but not least possible option is to use a Bluetooth proxy on an ESP32 device running ESP Home. It may sound complicated, but quite the opposite, it is not. If you want to know more about this Bluetooth proxy option, I can recommend to watch this video of mine, where I am explaining everything in details. Now, without further ado, I'll add the iBeacon in Home Assistant, and I'll attach this iBeacon device to my keys, for example, so I can track them. Let's see this.
And I'll start typing integrations. Then I'll select navigate integrations. And here it is. My iBeacon tracker is auto-detected by Home Assistant. If that is not the case with you, you can try to add Bluetooth integration first by clicking on Add Integration and typing Bluetooth. And you have to select this and install it. After that, after a while, the iBeacon tracker should be auto-detected by Home Assistant and you only have to click on this Configure button. Do you want to set up iBeacon tracker? Submit. Success. And I'm ready. How easy was that? Let's see what I got now. This is it. I think I have to wait a bit before the entities behind this iBeacon tracker become available in Home Assistant. Okay, 1 minute later and few presses of this button on the iBeacon, on the Physicom iBeacon, I now have two devices and 10 entities. Let's see them. I'll click on this and then I'll click on the first one. Estimated distance is 0 meters and I have 3 sensors that are hidden. They're not very useful. Power, vendor and signal strength. Actually, they have no values for now. Let's see the second device. The estimated distance of the second device is 400 meters. And again, I have the same 3 hidden sensors. I'll go back to the first device, which now is stating 1 meter estimated distance. Again, that's the distance between the iBeacon and my Bluetooth receiver and transmitter. And now I'll move this Physicom iBeacon far away from here to see if this sensor will be updated. Okay, I moved the sensor 7 steps away from here. Let's see what this sensor will say. It is updated 1 minute ago. This is Bluetooth low energy protocol, guys. It is not working in real time in order to preserve the battery. The updates happen once in several minutes. I'll go back and I'll see the second device. The estimated distance is staying at 400 meters here. I'm not sure why is this second device. I don't know. And the first one is staying at 1 meter, which is not okay. Which is far from okay. Okay, the estimated distance is now 3 meters. Good. I must say that the meters are above 3, maybe 4 or 5. But never mind, this sensor is working. The Home Assistant iBeacon integration was a breeze. Now, let's make a Home Assistant iBeacon automation that will be activated when the iBeacon changes its estimated distance. Okay, I get back the iBeacon device next to me and the estimated distance of the sensor is showing 0 meters away from the Home Assistant. And now I'll create a simple automation. For that, I'll click on the C button and I'll start typing automations. Then I'll select Navigate Automations and I'll click on Create Automation. I'll start with an empty automation and as a trigger, I'll use the state. The entity will be my iBeacon, this one. I still don't know why I have two very similar devices added by this integration. If you happen to know that, let me know in the comments. But this one is actually updating the estimated distance sensor, so I'll use that. So I'll select that. And if the state of this device becomes unavailable, that means the device is out of reach. It is more than 400 meters away from here and I have no connection with it. That means it is not here in my home and I want to catch that. And this is my first trigger. The next one will be more precise. It will be of type numeric state. The entity will be my estimated distance, this one. And if it is above 2 meters, I can type here whatever number I wish. But in order to test this automation, I want to be more than 2 meters. And I think I'm ready. The first trigger will be activated if this device becomes unavailable. I can even define here for how many minutes this device should stay in this unavailable state, but I'll leave that to zeros for now.
And the second trigger is if it goes above 2 meters away from the Home Assistant, activate this action. So I have no conditions for this automation. I'll use CoService action. The service will be persistent notification create, which will create a new notification that will be visible right here with the message: your iBeacon goes above 2 meters away from here. And that's it. I'll click save. The name of the automation will be iBeacon 2 meters away, and I'll click save. And now I can test this automation by just moving this iBeacon away from here. Good, I moved the iBeacon away, and I'll press the E button, which will show me the entity filter, and I'll type FSC, estimated distance. The current state of the sensor is updated 20 seconds ago, and as you can see here, I have a new notification saying your beacon goes above 2 meters away from here, which means that everything is working as expected. Great! If some of the words or acronyms that I'm using during this video are not so clear for you, feel free to download my smart home glossary, where you can find simple but useful explanations of the most common smart home words. The glossary is absolutely free, and you can download it right now from my website automatelike.pro/glossary. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill, and I'm done speaking. Bye!